opposite the other night in the first four, along with Matt Dickey. Justin John Williams will get it going as well as Kennard Jackson. Pittsburgh Panthers will counter with Ashton Gibbs, Wanamaker, Gilbert Brown, Nasir Robinson, and Gary McGee, the senior. Eddie Biedenbaugh, a lifer in the coaching profession, now in his 15th season at UNC Asheville. He was the player of the decade at North Carolina State, played for the likes of Case and Maravich, went on to have an outstanding career beginning at Davidson, where he started some coaching careers. Names like Barnes, Bezdelic, and Bob McKillop. Worked for Hugh Durham in the 83 Final Four as an assistant coach with Vern Fleming and Terry Fair and company. And there's Jamie Dixon, one of the rock stars of college basketball. He's done literally everything but take the next step and make it to a Final Four. No one got to 200 wins in eight seasons and beyond any faster than did Jamie Dixon.
And I think this could be the year, Tim, and you look at it, and if they've always been a very good rebounding team and a tough defensive team, this year I think they're scoring the ball a lot better.
This afternoon's game is brought to you in HD TV by LG. Life's good.
I wouldn't be surprised early on if UNC Asheville is in a little bit more of a flow, having played against Arkansas Little Rock the other day. They faced game action already. And if anything that we've seen in the NCAA in the past, that Pitt has gotten off to some slow starts in their first round game.
Another thing to consider about Pittsburgh is they're not the kind of team, even when they're playing at their best, that blows people out. They are not an explosive team necessarily. And because of that reason, I think UNC Asheville believes that they can hang in this game. UNC Asheville came into this building, played Georgetown earlier in the year, and only lost by 10 points. So this stage is nothing new to Biedenbaugh. He'll take on all comers in college basketball. No one plays any more guaranteed money games than does UNC Asheville.
Well, and when you have a backcourt like Dickey and Prim, you feel confident every time you step out on the floor.
Our officials for this afternoon's second game in the second round here in Washington, D.C., Chris Rastatter, along with Brett Smith and Jeb Hartness.
I think a lot could determine early on how this game is officiated, Tim, that Pitt playing in the Big East is used to a very rugged style of play, and if they face a tight whistle, it could be to their disadvantage.
They have come out of the Big East tournament losing in the opening round to Connecticut in a very close game, lost thanks to Kimball Walker at the end of yet another game, and more on him coming later from Washington, D.C. But the Panthers, I think, want to prove a point after those early exits in the Big East tournament. They've exited first round out of New York the last 3 years. Opening tip to Pitt, and down low, McGee gathers it in. Rebound to Jumpin' John Williams. He'll get plenty of those. You talk about a vertical leap, he's got it. Tremendous shot blocker at only 6'4". Dickey, not there. And Wanamaker tries to run it down. Out of bounds, it will belong to UNC Asheville.
Well, this is the thing, that Jamie Dixon's teams have been built on defense and rebounding, and that's what let them down in that game against UConn. They had the lead, but then just were outworked on the boards in the last 8 minutes of that game.
J.P. Prim, junior from Dixon, Tennessee, played at Dixon County High School. Robinson gets the deflection. I'm going to say he touched it last. It will be UNC's ball as you look at those America's guests that we were talking about, including a win at Auburn.
And that was their new building. Yeah, it was a rather rude way to come in the first game played in that building to get a win on the road.
Baseline extended. That one won't fall for Williams, and Pitt lost it out of bounds again.
Well, that time Gibbs fighting for it with Robinson, and you can't complain a little bit on a hustle play like that, but Pitt a little rusty here to start in this first minute of the ball game.
Prim off the inbounds pass. From the seat of his pants, he knocks it down, and UNC Asheville takes the early lead.
Not a great shooter, but a scorer, and he matched Dickey with 22 points in that first round win.
Had to come from behind to do it. UNC Asheville played from behind most of the night in game. Gibbs with a three ball.
He's the one guy that Asheville really has to lock in on the perimeter.
See how undersized this UNC Asheville team is. Kennard Jackson inside at 6'4". Prim with a crier off the front rim, and Gibbs brings it back down for Pittsburgh. McGee rejected by Williams. Jumping John leading the way for UNC Asheville. And Gibbs comes back. Gibbs with that superior size able to tip it in, though Kennard Jackson had the position.
Well, that's what McGee, and he's not a guy that they're going to dump it down to a lot in the low block. He plays a lot out of the screen and roll, but nice job staying with it after his shot got initially blocked.
Williams, nice reverse pivot, unable to get it to go, and it's out of bounds to Pitt. How about this screen, Mike?
Well, the look right there, that screen frees him up, and that's what you have to do. That's what he does in that offense. He gets other guys shots, and then he goes to the front of the rim for the offensive rebound.
Well, these seniors on this squad, Gary McGee, Gilbert Brown, they've really meant a lot to the future of this program and how fantastic it's been, as that foul is committed by Matt Dickey.
And that's going to be an issue in this game. Can Matt Dickey stay with Brad Wanamaker? That is a tough physical matchup for him. And is it going to mount and mount the fouls? If they can get Dickey out of the game, it'll be a huge bonus for the Panthers.
Reach in foul against Chris Stevenson. DJ Cunningham will check into the game now for UNC Asheville.
You can see the look right there. I mean, he was looking away, but those are the ones you really can't afford to give away.
Now, when they go to their bench, Mike, and they're able to bring in DJ Cunningham, the sophomore from Waterford, Ohio, they get a little larger in their front line, does UNC Asheville. He's been a walking mash unit all season long, three different injuries keeping him out of games, but he's a raw talent and somebody they can use today. Stevenson, the dribble drive. Not there, stays with it though. Saves it up. Prim. On the wing and a three ball for Stevenson. Boy, credit Prim for keeping that ball alive and not out of bounds.
Well, this is what Asheville is gonna have to do, is win those 50-50 balls against Pitt, and results in a three-point look. Stevenson only 25% from behind the arc.
19 of 79 on the season. McGee hitting the offensive glass, but this one's retrieved by Williams.
I think that Gilbert Brown who missed that shot is going to be a big key for this Pitt team if they're to advance in the NCAAs.
Dickey, tough pass from baseline to baseline, and Gibbs got in the way. Here, Robinson, always helpful down on low block for Pittsburgh. He and McGee trying to work it on a high-low. And the foul spot, that ball was kicked, so it will remain Pittsburgh's basketball with 20 seconds left on the shot clock. Almost 4 minutes gone here in Washington. Wanamaker with a bad pass to Gibbs, and it's out of bounds. Timeout. We're tied at 5. 16:01. I beg your pardon. We're 1 second above the 4 minute automatic television timeout zone.
And in general, especially in a 1-16 game, Tim, the lower seed, you want to try to stay in it, not get blown out early, take that big knockout punch. And so far, Asheville doing a nice job. Hit a couple of shots. Pittsburgh a little casual with the basketball.
Stevenson, very active, couple of ball fakes, and he's able to drop it through, and UNC Asheville by 2. Chris Stevenson has 5 of their 7.
And really a sloppy defense that time. Stevenson getting great position.
Brown pulls up. And again, another recycle for Pitt. Asheville forced to play a lot of zone. When you're outmanned to the extent that they are, and there's a foul, a reach in that will go against J.P. Prim. So, you wonder why they call this the big dance?
We advise. Bud Light, like most advertisers, we're going to run a 3D commercial this year. In fact, we made one, but it didn't test well. Here we go. Actually, it tested too well. We concluded that running this commercial would have been inappropriate, okay. So we didn't. You're welcome, America.
It's the sure sign of a good time. The just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
If you believe access to your financial advisor should be a right, not a privilege.
Join the nearly 7 million who invest with Edward Jones. Ranked highest in investor satisfaction by J.D. Power and Associates 2 years in a row.
Do you mind if I ask Sheila out?
Of course not. We broke up 6 months ago. But I don't think she'd go for a guy like...
She said she'd love to. She can't wait to see me. Really? She's wanted me to ask her out for over a year now. She just sent me a video.
Hi, Steven.
Oh, can I see that?
Yeah.
Can't wait for a date.
In the network, sparks fly faster. AT&T is getting faster with 4G. Rethink possible.
What's my motto? Play to win. What's the key? Logistics.
It takes planning. Everybody on the same page. Check this out. This is my playbook.
Serious business. Did it at the UPS store.
Bam!
Color, pictures, charts, graphics. Nice, huh? I got a sweet deal. 4 color prints for a buck. I love logistics.
It says in the book we should play as a team.
Get 4 color prints for a dollar. Only at the UPS store and only for a limited time.
It's 2011. Wonder where the Durango's been for the last 2 years? Well, they toured around Europe, getting handling and steering lessons on those sporty European roads. It went back to school, got an advanced degree in technology. It's been working out, more muscle and less fat. It's only been 2 years, but it's done more in 2 years than most cars do in a lifetime.
Greg Gumbel in New York with an HP tournament update for you. Southwest Regional play in Denver over on TBS. Morehead State beginning to rain threes. On Louisville, they've jumped to a 57-52 lead, 5:16 to play in regulation. Back to Washington.
One of the most electrifying players in this tournament, Fareed. He can play for just about anybody, Greg, and we'll keep an eye on that as you look at all the scores. On our many platforms, Nasir Robinson gets three for the bucket.
Nasir Robinson.
On the other end, Prim takes it in and pumps, rattling it home. Nothing shy about UNC Asheville and J.P. Prim.
We talked about it, 40% from two, but 35% from three. And he and Dickie, anytime you have a formidable backcourt like that that can score, you feel pretty confident going out.
Robinson, Taylor just into the game, out of the timeout. He's rejected again, twice, jumping Johnny Williams, 23 in black, right. Beautifully done.
DJ Stephen, DJ Cunningham and Webb, it's all inside.
Wow, Cunningham and Williams combining to make life difficult for those Pitt bigs, and we're tied at 9.
But a nice job by Pittsburgh, not losing your composure, recycling the play and getting a bucket.
Eddie Biedenbaugh really loves Cunningham. Woodall, Trayvon Woodall comes into the game and gets an easy win for Pittsburgh. And it's 11-9 Panthers.
That time Prim tried to dribble through a double team, which is very tough to do against this good defensive ball club.
DJ Cunningham, sort of a pick and pop guy. That time steps by Stevenson. Under the boards with some help from Cunningham. The little guys can also jump, can't they?
Yeah, it was Cunningham inside. He talked about he's coming off the bench, but he's going to play a lot of minutes out there, Tim. He's a terrific passer out of the low post.
You noticed John Williams there, number 24, wearing that mask. He fractured his cheekbone running into Tyler Zeller earlier this year. Talking about that tough schedule they play, it included North Carolina. Gibbs feeds Trayvon Woodall. On the wing, Patterson. Lamar Patterson, the freshman from Lancaster, PA.
Very unselfish. Good job moving the basketball.
And there's a bump by Trayvon Woodall against Prim. The kind of ball movement you like to see if you're Jamie Dixon.
Yeah, that one extra pass, and Patterson clapping his hands so he could hear him on the wing. Got a good open look.
Jamie Dixon, his first game coached in the Garden in New York against Alabama. Won his very first game in a coaches versus cancer matchup. And 214 wins later, here he is, one of the favorites. And it's punching a ticket to the Final Four.
Tim, it's not easy to move from an assistant job to the head job in the same school, and he did that seamlessly when Ben Howland left for UCLA, and they never missed a beat.
He made one call to his president and said, if you give me the opportunity, I won't embarrass you. I'd say he lived up to that.
No doubt about it. He's built that into one of the best jobs in the country.
Prim.
And as a result of that, he has been very loyal because there have been a lot of suitors over the years for his job.
You think? A lot of people had him going to a lot of West Coast jobs from the time he was 4 years into this job at Pittsburgh. Gilbert Brown, left free on the wing, decides to drive. Dickey with a quick outlet to his friend Prim. Very rare that you see a Jamie Dixon coach team give up a runout. 14-11 Panthers.
You talk about where turnovers occur, and when they're out above the free throw line, it's the first pass of the fast break. And if you're Asheville, you want to try to create as many easy scoring opportunities as you can.
Prim a little gimpy when he came down after that layup. Patterson, Dickey and Prim collaborate on the rebound. Prim still trying to shake it off. We'll walk it up the floor. Prim and Stevenson have combined for all 11 points. We've yet to hear from Dickey. Well over 8 minutes gone by. Cunningham. Loose ball. Run down by UNC Asheville. That's Eric Stubbs keeping it alive, number 42 in black and blue. Prim off the pick and roll. Dickey, I beg your pardon, and we've got a foul underneath. Timeout. 14-11, Pittsburgh by three. Stubbs got that foul.
The name has endured because the car has. Only one car can be called the most durable, longest lasting in its class. Presenting the One, the 34 mile per gallon Accord from Honda.
There are a lot of questions out there about retirement. Let Fidelity help you find the answers. Our investment professionals work with you to help you make the most of your retirement and enjoy the life you've saved for. Fidelity Investments, where leading companies and millions of people go to get the real answers they need. Call today.
Five oceans, seven continents, whatever it takes, wherever it takes us. America's Navy, a global force for good.
Fierce acceleration, the all-new XUV 825i will shatter your expectations.
Get great deals and service on legendary John Deere equipment. Stop by our dealership today.
Introducing the Thunderbolt by HTC. Immense power, scorching speed. The first phone strong enough to run on the fastest, most advanced 4G network in America.
Can't get to your TV or computer for March Madness? Take the action with you and watch every game live on your iPhone or iPad. Visit the iTunes store to download the free app now.
So far, UNC Asheville has acquitted themselves nicely here in Washington, D.C., and let's get our Powerade sideline report from Lewis Johnson. Lewis?
All right, Tim, thanks so much. Well, the UNC Asheville is really having a whirlwind experience, and let's give you an idea of the timeline since their win of the first four back in Dayton to getting here to D.C. Now, they had that win over Arkansas Little Rock that ended about 9:15 on Tuesday. Left UD Arena about 10:30, back at the hotel at 11 with a half hour to pack. Got to the Dayton Airport by midnight, wheels up 12:30, landed at Washington Dulles at 3 a.m. A short practice here on Wednesday evening, and here they are. And the players and coaches are saying they've enjoyed the presidential treatment and the opportunity to be a part of March Madness.
Yeah, those charter flights are better than charter buses, which is what they're more accustomed to. As Wanamaker hits the bucket, and it's 16-11 Pitt.
Yeah, I've been impressed, Tim. And they look like they believe like they should be on the court. And they've also matched the physicality of Pitt, which I had a little question of coming in. But they have really been solid here early.
Louisville is leading Moorhead. Very close game between those two teams over on TBS. You want to go check it out? Been a magnificent game all the way through, back and forth. Take a look at them. That ball went off the front rim as the shot clock was winding down for Dickey, who still failed to stretch so far in this game.
Well, and you got to think that he might have been number one with Prim 1A on the scouting report. But Dickey, the thing with him, he's made so many big shots that he has not had many good looks at all early in this game. 0 of 3, all of them 3-point opportunities.
McGee finding Wanamaker, cutting into the lane.
He's the guy who sets the tone with this team. He's all business when he goes out on the floor. And we talked about Gibbs, but Brad Wanamaker may be the guy you want with the ball in his hands at the end of the game.
Pitt's got 8 field goals, Mike, by 6 different guys, so they're spreading it around. The largest lead of the afternoon. So far, the Panthers have blanketed Dickey. Cunningham working in on McGee, forces him into a jump shot, well defended.
Well, and the key there, Gary McGee is capable of guarding him one-on-one, so they can stay at home on perimeter players.
Patterson driving, and Nasir Robinson on the putback is fouled. Watch every tournament game live online with NCAA March Madness on demand at mmod.ncaa.com. Cunningham picked up the foul for UNC Asheville, his first. Let's get an update on J.P. Prim from our Lewis Johnson.
Yeah, Tim, you see him coming back in the game. He was in a lot of pain a few minutes ago. I've been told that they just decided to put this compression sleeve on his left knee. You see him adjusting it right now, but he'll have to manage the pain, but okay to play.
Wonder if he may have hyperextended it a little bit when he was on that run out, trying to catch up to that baseball pass from Dickey. Cunningham tries to save it, running right into our cameraman underneath.
He's getting a nice shot of the ceiling right now. He's getting a hand up by the referees and everybody else who wants to be around him.
Nate Spearman working diligently to get back up.
And that's the toughest position for a cameraman on the court. You get a lot of action coming right at you, and even Prim going over to give him a hand.
Nate the skate getting the job done for us underneath. Gilbert Brown. Good closeout that time by Stevenson. The outlet to Prim. Rejected by Brown.
Gilbert Brown, by far the best athlete on this team, really saving a play. And you can't fault Prim in that situation. It was a one-on-two break to him, but Eddie Biedenbaugh talked about getting out and running, and that's just an opportunity maybe to score an easy point, but Brown saved the play.
I mean, let's face it, they've got to have a few runouts and opportunities at easy baskets if they want to hang with the number one seed here in the Southeast region. Cunningham reaching in, picked up that foul. The second. And that will force Biedenbaugh to get Kennard Jackson back on the floor, the junior from West Palm Beach, Florida. Back in for Cunningham.
Well, again, you get a much smaller team out there for Asheville right now, and where it may not manifest with direct passes to McGee, but it might on the offensive glass.
In many respects, what you're looking at is the difference between the so-called Division I school from a non-power conference and the best from a power league is Gibbs hits the jumper. UNC Asheville just as athletic as they are, not tall or wide enough.
And are going to have to play a zone almost exclusively against this team, which is going to force Ashton Gibbs to step up, which he did.
Prim off the bounce. Wanamaker feeds to Sierra Robinson. Alley looping to McGee.
You know, McGee has improved so much over his 4 years at Pitt, a guy who could barely get on the court as a freshman. A very integral part of this team.
Stevenson in traffic. That was just a shot really out of frustration, could not find anyone as the Panthers defense has really closed down UNC Asheville in the last 5 minutes. One for their last nine. McGee, Williams again, jumping John. What a defender he is. 43 blocks on the season, 252 in his career. He truly can jump out of the gym. And sometimes we need guys to jump out of the gym, not into Nate the Skate. Are you kidding me?
Turbo. Buick. Turbo. Buick. Turbo. Buick. Don't worry, you'll get used to the sound of it. The 6-speed direct injected 2011 Regal Turbo. New from Buick.
It's another perfect day out here today.
Can I get you anything else?
We gotta get back to work.
We even saw a kid taking a bath in a water fountain.
Whoop, I spoke too soon. This just in, a freak storm is blowing into the area. Going to be experiencing hurricane force winds and dense fog, followed by sheets of driving rain. Stay inside, hunker down, grab a beer. This is going to be a long one.
Buffalo Wild Wings, Wings Beer Sports.
We're receiving reports of hail the size of. Oh boy.
Energy, we cross the hall. Gravity, we bounce the ball. Tenacity, I'll beat you all, so make your play and I'll watch you fall.
Zigzag from the back of the zigzag.
Oh, hey, buddy.
Oh, yeah. Mike, I got a little constructive criticism for you. There's one thing I don't like about your commercials.
This is gonna be good.
Everybody's always showing you their underwear. It's not realistic.
Now me, I just got these.
Comfort Flex waistband. Doesn't pinch, doesn't bind, nothing, man. I can get so low in these. Look at this. Look at this movement. I'm like a ballerina in these things. I could take you, I bet, in these. I bet I could take you in.
The Comfort Flex waistband. Won't pinch, won't bind. New from Hanes.
Hey,
Life is full of little twists and turns. ING can help you take the right steps along the way. The first step is finding your number, the amount you need to save to retire the way you want while protecting the ones you love. Learn more at ing.com/US.
Greg Gumbel in New York, over on TBS in Denver. Louisville leading Morehead State by two, and then this happened. Vern Lundquist.
Here comes the play. Goodman at the free throw line. Jumper.
Oh! Huggins!
Harper!
3.5 seconds remaining. We'll keep you updated. Back to Washington.
How about that?
137 against Louisville in Denver. 62-61, the final. So number 13,
AP picks up his second foul. Well, everything is for sale and nothing is off limits on TruTV's number one hit show, Hardcore Pawn. You won't believe what's in store every Tuesday at 9 p.m. on TruTV.
And then the thing that you like about Ashton Gibbs is he's better on the road, averaging 18 points a game in true road games, which is usually the opposite of players, but his game travels very well.
Phil Simms must be jumping for joy. His alma mater, Morehead State, has just beaten Louisville.
Wow, what an incredible result. But they had the best player on the floor this year going into that game.
Yep. And right away, the Big East dominance storyline will begin to take shape in this year's NCAA tournament. Dickey. Yes, count it. It could be a four-point play as Gibbs picks up the personal. Boy, that was a much-needed hoop for UNC Asheville. In a lot of respects, they were beginning to teeter here, trying to compete with the bigger, stronger Panthers.
Well, and they got a nice screen for him. It's one of the few open looks that he's had in rhythm.
Well, his first, and it turns into a four-point play, and they had gone, Mike, 5 minutes and 59 seconds without a basket.
But and you touched on it, Tim, and this is not a Pitt team that's built to run away from you offensively. And they'll grind it out, they'll get on the board, but they cannot be explosive and go up on you 20 like that. So if Asheville just hangs with it, plays in this zone, they can stay in this game.
Taylor fouled by Williams on the backside. Dante Taylor, the sophomore out of New York, by way of National Christian Academy, is a load.
But he's, you know what, in that situation, Tim, it's not a bad idea if it's not one of your key players. Dante Taylor only 56% from the free throw line, so don't let him get a dunk. Make him go to the free throw line and prove it.
He's one of five Panthers with more than 130 rebounds. You talk about how they get the job done on the glass, and he is one of the really few McDonald's All-America types that Jamie Dixon has been able to procure.
Yep.
Well, generally speaking, Pitt is a team made up of 3- and 4-year guys. Very few one and done types on Jamie Dixon's squad. That's palming the call and a turnover committed by Nasir Robinson.
And I would say, for the most part, you look at the characteristics of his player, maybe a little undersized at their position, but tough.
Oh, yeah.
And they defend, and they all rebound their position very well.
Think about the guards, Mike, from Carl Krauser to Lavance Fields, inside guys like Sam Young.
New York City,
yep.
You know, guards that love to live in the paint.
And then guys that played larger than their size. You know, Dwan Blair was one of the few really big guys, truly big guys, that Pitt had. Trayvon Woodall is fouled. Taking it inside the lane, Jerron Lane came over to give a little bit of help, as did Kennard Jackson, and Kennard was guilty of the foul, his first. Well, on this St. Patrick's Day, and happy St. Patrick's Day to you, my friend. Earlier this year, to sort of celebrate it, a tour of Ireland was made, and Gary McGee kissed the Blarney Stone, me boy, as did Jamie Dixon. They're hoping it pays some dividends on this St. Paddy's Day today.
By the way, from this point on, I'll be referred to by you as Timothy O'Brando, okay?
I'll pass on that.
Party pooper.
Lamar Patterson comes back into the game for Pitt.
Nice try to become Irish for a day.
Well, I was named after an Irish athletic director by my father at a Jesuit school. Stevenson, he was very creative early in this game, and Dickey, who has that one field goal, is looking to light it up again. Feeds Williams, nice play.
You talk about undersized him, but because of his ability to lift, that Williams can play still above the rim, even at 6'4".
Pitt leading by 9, 26-17. Robinson rejected by Williams again. Boy, can that guy get up. You talk about hops. He is right up there with the best of them. Off the ball, a foul spotted. That will go against Lamar Patterson.
Well, I talked about it, playing above the rim, and this is just a stout defensive play rising up on the guy, Nasir Robinson, who's taking it right at you, but he gave a little space, went up and took care of business.
He had 6 blocks in the Big South title game. It's a record for that conference. And again, at 6'4", and his wingspan, he's played so much larger than his stature. Pitt has 10 more field goals. They've had 5 shots blocked in the game. Loose ball, shot clock under 10. Stevenson pumps for 3. Too strong. Rebound to Trayvon Woodall. And that pass from Patterson went into the front row of seats and well beyond the broadcasters and press corps. Nice work inside by Williams. Jumping John, jumping for joy in March.
Another billionaire is broke. C. Montgomery Burns has lost his entire fortune.
Applebee's 2-for-20 menu now jazzed up with the flavors of Bourbon Street, like new Cajun shrimp pasta. One appetizer, 2 entrees, $20. Only at Applebee's. Catch all the games here.
Lawn gnomes, bird baths, and the competition are officially on notice. Introducing Craftsman Turntide Tractors, a best-in-class 8-inch turning radius, 30% tighter than any other tractor. Craftsman, trust in your hands.
Capital One has asked yours truly to talk about the Venture Card Match My Miles Challenge. They're so confident their miles are better, they'll match the miles you've earned on your airline credit card up to 100,000 on a new Venture Card.
That's unbelievable.
Believe it. Venture Card miles are good on any airline, anytime. It's like an upgrade from this to this. Sign up for a Venture Card at CapitalOne.com today and get up to 100,000 miles.
What's in your wallet? Impressive, right?
How does vanishing deductible work?
That boulder is like your insurance deductible.
Big and always hanging over your head.
But vanishing deductible from Nationwide Insurance takes $100 off your deductible every year you're a safe driver until...
Amazing! You saved me.
Oh, it was just an analogy. Oh. But you're welcome. You're welcome. Oh. Nationwide is on your side. That's very good.
Everything is for sale, and nothing is off limits.
Oh, my God!
Hardcore Pawn, every Tuesday at 9 on TruTV.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Applebee's, the Capital One Venture Card, and by Northwestern Mutual.
Take a look at our game summary here in Washington, D.C. as Pittsburgh leads at 26-17. A lot of shots on goal, and UNC Asheville hanging in with hustle plays.
Yeah, and then really not a big disparity at the free throw line, so that certainly helps. But I like the fact that, UNC Asheville has matched their physical style play. A lot of that is John Williams. He has been very dominant at 6'4 in the paint on the defensive end.
You want to see a wire game, you might want to check out the matchup between Temple and Penn State. Temple leading by one, 62-61, under a minute left. Over on TNT. Dickey not there, and the rebound collected by Nasir Robinson. Well, we had a buzzer beater today in our first game. Huge upset between Morehead State and Louisville. And now Temple and Penn State going down to the wire. Robinson, McGee keeping it alive. Really not a fair fight underneath, is it? And yet UNC Asheville comes out of there with it.
You have three offensive rebounds, but you come up with no points.
Lane, that's a block. Jerron Lane taking it right to the rack. The sophomore from Greenville, North Carolina. Well, coming up on AT&T at the half, scores and highlights from all of those games, including our buzzer beater earlier today, the latest tournament news, and the Naismith Watch presented by AT&T. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. We've got almost as many guys in the studio, G-Man, as I think any one of these coaches can turn to on their bench.
I just hope Charles stays awake for the whole day. That'll be a win.
Sir Charles is happy to know that I get verbally abused the way he did when he was a Sixer. Alongside you.
I want to ask him about that UNC Asheville Auburn result in the beginning of the year.
I know it meant a lot to you when he was honored in Philadelphia when he invited you, and you guys have been great friends through the years. Stevenson, Alina, not to be, but keeping it alive underneath. Great work by Stevenson and Williams. And this crowd, much of it, beginning to pull mightily for the upstarts from Asheville, North Carolina.
That's the one thing. Get those 16 seeds. They'll have a lot of constituents outside of Pitt fans.
And the tip-in for Gilbert Brown. It's the first field goal in the last 5:15 for the Panthers. 28-21. Ball was knocked away. It'll be Pitt basketball. Nice work by, among others, Trayvon Woodall. Yeah, get all the March Madness highlights, box scores, and the TV schedule for TBS, CBS, TNT, and TruTV at NCAA.com. Well, Eddie Biedenbaugh's got to be proud of the way his troops have handled the first 20 minutes, Mike. They've hung tough. Gibbs, kind of a Reggie Miller move there. He was trying to induce the foul from beyond the arc. Eddie Biedenbaugh really wants to get an overrule here, get a little help from one of the officials, but they both agree it's Pittsburgh's basketball.
Like I said, there's really nobody. Gibbs has got 6 points, and he's the leading scorer for Pitt right now, but there are seven guys between 2 and 6 points.
Well, Ashton Gibbs really wants the ball. Trayvon Woodall didn't give it to him when he wanted it. And off the ball, that's a 3 second violation against McGee.
It happens sometimes if you're big and you try to anticipate a shot out front and it doesn't happen, you can get that call.
Jamie Dixon said of Gary McGee, he's the best defensive center he's ever had. Now that is a mouthful.
I don't know, a guy that works harder in the weight room and has worked harder to get where he is. And in the last 8 years, Jamie Dixon has had 4 of the most improved players in the conference, and it speaks to his coaching ability.
No question. McGee with the rebound. Gibbs pumps. Missed everything.
Yeah, that was I haven't taken a shot in a while, and I want to take a shot.
Don't forget that Temple and Penn State game coming down to the wire on TNT. If you'd like to check it out, now's the time to go over. Williams is fouled, taking it right up against the body of the taller Gary McGee. Gilbert Brown also came over, providing some help, and it's Gilbert picking up the personal. And
you know what, to a player, you can say all you want to him, but I'm sure there was a little question in their players' minds for Asheville about, you know, how are we going to do it? Do we belong out on the same court with Pitt? And, you know, I think this first 20 minutes has gone a long way to answering that question.
Number 23, John Williams in the line shooting two.
That game between Temple and Penn State is tied at 64 with 11.4 seconds remaining.
It's not easy to follow a legend, but Fran Dunphy has done a terrific job there following John Chaney.
He really has. You know, Franny was on a United States national team with Mike Krzyzewski back in 1971. Coach K actually backed up Dunphy on that team. He was a heck of a guard himself. Look at that defensive play. Dickey and company getting involved along with Lane. And Eddie Biedenball wants a timeout. UNC Asheville has made a move and could be within one basket of pulling to within three or two. Dickey limping back to the sideline.
You know, I'll have a light beer too.
Sure. Regular bottle or a Miller Lite Vortex bottle?
Regular. I don't see what's so special about that one.
Well, it's got grooves. Maybe if you weren't wearing sunglasses in a dimly lit bar, you'd see that.
Just came from outside.
It's midnight.
Man up and choose the Vortex bottle. Its specially designed grooves let that great Pilsner taste flow right out.
Got a Vortex bottle.
And they're playing your song.
It's not my song.
Excite, the new fragrance from Axe. Even angels will fall.
Now at Sonic, there's premium beef hot dogs, like the Chicago dog with hot peppers, tomatoes, and a pickle.
How about the New York dog with spicy mustard, sauerkraut, and grilled onions? Come on.
Hold your horses, partners. There's also the All-American dog, mustard, ketchup, and relish.
Wait, wait. You must try chili cheese corny from my home.
No, wait a minute. What kind of accent is that?
Russian. There's a lot of Russian living on Coney Island.
Just $1.99 each. Hot dogs, made with 100% pure beef. Now at Sonic.
What are you looking at?
Logistics.
Ben, UPS guy?
Well, you see Ben, I see logistics.
Logistics.
Think, Ben is new markets. Ben is global access, China and beyond. Ben is a smarter supply chain. Ben is higher margins. Happier customers, everybody wins.
Logistics.
Exactly.
See you guys tomorrow.
After 100 years of hybrid technology, someone finally built one you'll actually enjoy driving. The 360 horsepower, 32 miles per gallon Infiniti M Hybrid, the high performance hybrid.
Greg Gumbel in New York, West Regional action in Tucson over on TNT. Penn State and Temple tied. Final seconds, Kevin Harlan.
Tipping, Fernandez. Frazier defends to advance and he puts it down! Point four to play. Jackson to inbound. It goes off to Frazier. It's over. And Temple
is a 66-64 winner. They'll await the winner of San Diego State and Northern Colorado.
Wow. Kevin Harlan, along with Reggie Miller and Dan Bonner, got a great one there. And Temple prevails against Penn State.
Great win for the A-10 and Fran Dunphy's squad. That was, you know, we talk about, Tim, that all the great, and I mentioned John Chaney, all the great teams that he had at Temple and all the things that he did, he never made the Final Four.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You know, it just shows you how hard it is to get there and to win championships in this event.
No question about it.
Well, UNC Asheville was down by 12, Mike, at the 6:05 mark, and Matt Dickey hit his first bucket. It was a three-pointer that turned into a four-point play. And since that time, they've gone on a 12-5 run and trailed by five. And the officials are looking at the clock at the scorers table and really unsure as to why this stoppage has taken place. Apparently, we are not in contact with the officials as to why we are having this break in the action. They seem to be looking at something, and hopefully we'll get an explanation from Jeb Hartness. He's coming over to check with Mike as we are in the midst of this stoppage.
It's actually a timing issue. They just came over and said it's a shot clock and a game clock.
That occurred on a change of a possession when UNC Asheville stole the basketball. I think that's what it's about. With our thanks to Jeb Hartness for coming over and explaining that to us. It has been taken care of. Prim is back on the floor. And he's got the basketball now. 10-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. 16th seed UNC Asheville hanging right with Pittsburgh. We're in the opening half in Washington. Isolation for Dickey. What do you think here? Looks like it now. Hole number one. Williams almost with an acrobatic play, and then Prim with a poor decision. That was a very poor decision to reach in and commit that foul. That's his third, which is what you don't want. And then you give a freebie with the clock stop to Pittsburgh. But how about that? It's like he's shot out of a cannon.
Great ups, and just diving down onto the offensive glass after setting that screen, but the ball took a little funny bounce. And normally with a good shooter like Dickey, you get that soft rebound in the front of the rim, but that one came off a little hot.
Well, the anxiety of it all is Prim sits down now, and you know he wishes he'd had that last 5 seconds back.
Well, and because McGee steps out on the shooter, it allows him in a free run at the rim. Maybe he just got a little bit too far in that time.
Wanamaker gets the free throw. That's a four-point swing. Blows out the half. Dickey with the clock winding down. A solo off the jump stop. Oh, the bank is open. With 0.5 remaining. Wow, what a move by Dickey. A five-point game. Use the window when you can. Oh, what a kiss.
At Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we keep things pretty simple.
Simply treat our customers the way they should be treated.
That's been our philosophy for more than 55 years.
It's no more complicated than that.
Maybe that's why Enterprise is America's favorite place to rent a car. It's about treating customers the right way.
Let us show you what that means.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
We welcome you back. Pittsburgh leading it by five. We're going to take a look at that last bucket by Matt Dickey. He only has two in the game, Mike, but both have been timely. I think they were looking at this to see how much time they should put back on the clock for Jamie Dixon.
What? It doesn't stop when it goes through. I just don't understand. It's going to be tough for them to get a shot up here.
Well, what they determined was the ball went through the nets and Jamie called a timeout. So they did actually add 1.5 seconds to the clock. So with 2 seconds, they can go the length of the floor and hope for a catch and shoot. Ball was deflected. And now 0.6 remaining. Jamie playfully with the officials begging for an extra tenth of a second over there.
Well, still enough in theory for a catch and shoot.
Yep.
Ah.
52, Gary McGee.
Gary McGee checks back in the game for Gilbert Brown. Boy, halftime's going to be fun, huh? With a look at all of those incredible finishes that we had, Penn State, Temple, and Morehead State.
And a terrific 20 minutes by Asheville here.
Oh, absolutely. Indeed. They closed the half, Mike, on a 14-7 run.
Yeah, be down by five. Eddie Biedenbaugh's got to be very happy with his ball club.
The majority of this crowd is really behind the 16th seed. Let's go over to Lewis Johnson.
Thanks so much. Coach, you got a five-point lead against UNC Asheville. What are your concerns about the way this first half was played, and what are the adjustments?
Well, we turned it over a few too many times, gave them some buckets in transition. We got to hurt them more on the boards, too, as well. So those are the things we emphasized, and I didn't think we did as good a job as we wanted to.
All right, we'll see you back in the second half.
All right, Lewis.
Come on, let's go!
Coming up, AT&T in the half. Right here on CBS. Back after this word and a message from your local station.
Well, this year our garden is simply amazing. How did you do it?
Morris Hall of Fame. He's quite a guy, Eddie Biedenbaugh. You really, the longer you do this tournament, the more fantastic stories about lifers in the game of basketball. A true gym rat.
And even all those years later, you hear him talking about being Don. You know, that Pittsburgh still comes through in his voice.
Absolutely. Dickey, right on cue, gets the first bucket of the second half. He's got eight, and the lead is down to three for Pittsburgh.
And maybe that was the message that in what he found at the end of the first half. He had settled for jump shots early in this game, but very aggressive attacking the basket.
Gibbs, I thought, a couple of times in the first half was a little frustrated, forced up shots because of it. Inside Robinson, not there. McGee tips it in. He's been solid.
Yeah, we touched on it. They have to do a much better job of converting those opportunities into points. So a good start for Gary McGee.
One noticeable aspect of this lineup to start the second half, Ron Lane starting and J.P. Prim, who has the three fouls, being protected a bit by Biedenbaugh.
And Lane also a very good three-point shooter in his own right.
John Williams can't hit from the elbow. And McGee takes the rebound right off the deck. And a whale of the first day of the NCAA tournament in Mass as Dickey takes it in and draws the contact. Wanamaker coming over to pick up the foul. Talk about a chiseled star back in the 60s at North Carolina State. How about that look?
He was voted player of the decade for the Wolfpack in the 1960s. Played for Everett Case and Press Maravich and Norm Sloan, and then became an assistant under Norm Sloan, his first coaching position.
When you think about it, Mike, he was with the Final Four team with David Thompson, helped recruit those great players on arguably one of the greatest teams ever in NCAA tournament history, Towson, Burleson, and all of those guys. And then later in the 80s, when Dominic Wilkins left early to go to the NBA, there was Vern Fleming, Terry Fair, and others. He was on the staff with Hugh Durham, that other team in the Final Four that everyone forgets about. The year of Five Slamma Jamma and the Doctors of Dunk played, and Jimmy V came away with the national championship. He was with Hugh Durham that year. Gibbs nails a tray for Pitt.
Yeah, good penetration of the zone that time. That's one of the few good looks that he's had on the perimeter, and they need Ashton Gibbs to step up and be a dominant scorer in this half. He only had six first half points.
Well, the junior from Scotch Plains, New Jersey, got that one to go. Doesn't fall for Lane, and it's retrieved by Gilbert Brown. He gets it back into Gibbs' hands. Gibbs, right past Dickey. Strong move.
Starting to call his own number, being much more aggressive.
The sort of businessman's approach that this Pitt Panthers team has. Eddie Biedenbaugh recognizing that he needs to give his guys a break as they quickly fall behind by eight. Ashton Gibbs, the prototype Pitt guard, can beat you in a variety of ways.
Escape convention. Escape definition. Escape compromise. Introducing the most fuel-efficient luxury car available. The radically new 42-mile-per-gallon CT Hybrid from Lexus. Welcome to the the darker side of green.
Doesn't have to slow you down. From accident forgiveness and 24-hour claims assistance to a lifetime repair guarantee, we help you move on. To learn more, visit us today. Liberty Mutual Auto Insurance. Responsibility. What's your policy?
My name's Tate. I am Domino's Chicken.
Tate's got a lot of pressure on him.
We had this box made to find out what people think about the new recipe.
You see this? It's made with 100% white breast meat. It's not a bunch of different chicken bits all mashed together.
Imagine if your boss had the entire country rate your performance on a box of chicken.
I want to hear from people. That's the way we run this company.
So order a medium two-topping pizza with Tate's new chicken. Choose any two for $5.99 each and tell us how he did.
I'm not excited about the box at all.
Light beer, please.
Sure. More taste or less taste?
I don't really care.
Okay. When you change out of that European man thong, come back and I'll give you a Miller Lite.
But it's stylish.
It's not in this country.
Man up and choose a light beer with more taste. Grab a triple hops brewed Miller Lite with that great Pilsner taste.
Got a Miller Lite?
Look, we are the same. Robbie!
When was the last time your phone surprised you? In a good way. In a jaw to the floor, Netflix streaming, office deadline obliterating, work ninjing, Xbox Live on my phone, boo takasha, kind of way. You won't believe what Windows Phone can do, and what your old phone can't. Get the only phone with Office, Xbox Live, and thousands of apps. Get a Windows Phone for $99.99 at AT&T.
Greg Gumbel in New York with a tournament update for you. 7:46. We'll keep you updated. Back to Washington, D.C.
All right, Greg, thank you. Here, UNC Asheville coming out of a timeout after Ashton Gibbs went to work scoring five in a row. Dickey has the last 6 points for the Bulldogs of the Big South Conference, and J.P. Prim is coming onto the floor for the first time after being saddled with three fouls prior to the first half coming to an end.
Well, that was a good timeout by Eddie Biedenbaugh. He wants to keep this game under control, and the Pitt on a little bit of a run, starting to distance themselves.
Cunningham with the jump hook, can't get that one to go. He also came in out of that timeout. DJ Cunningham, the tall sophomore from Waterford, Ohio. Gibbs, the ball fake. Nice distribution inside of Nasir Robinson.
They look like a completely different offensive team here in the first 3 minutes of this half. Pitt much more aggressive, much more confident, and I think Ashton Gibbs has set the tone for them.
They are 4 for 5 from the floor in this half. All business. Nice pick. And there's Dickey, unable to get it to go, and Gilbert Brown gets the rebound. Now numbers, and Gibbs decides to pull up. Not there. Williams claims the rebound. Stevenson, length of the floor to Prim. A blow by on Wanamaker. Boy, nice pass by jumping John Williams out to Prim. He knew what to do with it. He and Stevenson both very active.
Well, Prim, and sensing the need to get some easy points in transition, leaked out that time after he saw his team. He's reasonably sure he's going to get the basketball.
Robinson challenging Cunningham. And DJ Cunningham picks up the foul. How about this pass? This is a thing of beauty.
Little skinny post here for Prim out in the wing, and he finishes. He knows he has to take advantage of it, even though Pitt had three guys bearing down on him.
I should give Stevenson the proper credit. That was his pass rather than Williams. He was right there with him. That was the third foul, by the way, on DJ Cunningham. And Nasir Robinson at the free throw line. Well, what a day it has been. Vern Lundquist and Bill Raftery had that incredible finish out in Denver, and Kevin Harlan in Tucson with Reggie Miller and Dan Bonner had that big win for Temple against Penn State. And of course, we had the Butler doing it again at the buzzer, courtesy Matt Howard, in our first game in the Southeast region. All those other games you see up at the top of your screen. The game gets exciting, and you see that score. Go over and see our friends at TNT, TBS, and CBS.
They've missed Dickey a couple times on that cut. A little UCLA cut, and he gets open down low.
Will be Brown. On the wing, can't get it to fall. McGee taps it out. Wanamaker lost it. Dickey has numbers. Oh, what a find. What a pass. A laser to Prim.
Four steals the game for Dickey. And now it's Jamie Dixon that blinks and wants a timeout.
Just when one thought it was sending 16 back where it belonged, a little return to sender. Matt Dickey in the prime to Prim. Count it.
We all have a bloodline, but it takes a bold spirit to say, it's my turn, then go out and prove it. The new 2011 Jeep Compass, genetically engineered with Jeep 4x4 capability, iconic beauty, and a red-blooded attitude all its own. The 2011 Jeep Compass, the evolution of a legendary bloodline. Well-qualified lessees can get a 2011 Jeep Compass Sport 4x2 for $239 a month.
You look at our tournament summary. I'm being told now that our friend, the governor, Bill Raftery, had an onions on that Morehead State Louisville game. Maybe a double order again. And Temple outlasting Penn State. That ended a long drought for Fran Dunphy in the NCAA tournament. So congratulations to him, and obviously a big win for the Atlantic 10, Mike, as you mentioned.
And not an upset, but certainly the lower seed, and they hold serve. Yeah, I'm just happy for him that he finally gets a win in the big dance.
Gilbert Brown fouled on the putback. And you can see all four regions are up and going. Games all around us in round two of the NCAAs.
What if a pill could make you rich and powerful?
You know how we can only access 20% of our brain? This lets you access all of it.
Where it will take us, you can't even imagine.
But what if it made you a target?
You have no idea what kind of an enemy I could be.
A fight? Don't know how to fight. Or do I? Worth the risk? What would you do?
Limitless. Rated PG-13. Starts Friday.
Today we're having a lunch intervention.
Who wants lunch? Come on now!
With KFC's $5 everyday meals.
Yeah, come on, it's free lunch, guys.
Come on. Original recipe. Awesome. Delicious chicken sandwich.
I haven't had that in a while.
Choose from five different meals with your choice of sides and a medium drink for just $5 every day.
Oh, listen, $5?
That's five for $5.
Unbelievable.
$5.
Can't beat it.
Are you ready for some KFC today? Today tastes so good.
Everybody touch, everybody tap, everybody move, everybody app. Everybody frag, everybody tweet, everybody shuffle, everybody beat. Everybody mobile, everybody global, everybody instant, everybody on.
For more businesses and more people, only HP is leading the way. HP, everybody on.
Have you ever woken up on the wrong side of the bed, minus the bed? Your brain is throbbing, feels like your face is in a plate of nachos, and for some reason, there's a big old horse and buggy in your room. Yeah, we've all been there. That's when I drink a Vitamin Water Revive. It's got B vitamins and potassium. It helps rehydrate me after these epic nights. Again, I'd like to apologize to Brother Hezekiah and all the good people of Lancaster, Pennsylvania.
I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know.
Let's see you fly now.
Look, more frequent flyer red tape.
Not on my watch.
Let that family fly.
I just wanted to use miles to take my family on vacation, but...
Let me guess, restrictions through the roof.
That's right.
Not anymore. Rapid Rewards has your back.
Join Rapid Rewards and enjoy unlimited reward seats, no blackout dates, and no red tape.
We'll be right back. We are back here in Washington, D.C. Pittsburgh leading by six. Tim Brando, Mike Gminski, Lewis Johnson, Gilbert Brown at the free throw line for Pitt. Really amazing to think, Mike, how UNC Asheville could just be absolutely bludgeoned on the glass to the extent that they've been, and yet still be very much in this game.
Well, I think the reason for that, Tim, is, and against a very good defensive ball club in Pitt, they only have four turnovers in the game, so they're getting shots. Now, they're not getting a lot of recycles on their own misses, but at least they're having positive possessions.
It should be mentioned, and I know we've touched on this many times, and I had the opportunity to be a part of one of the first opportunities for a 16 to beat a 1 Western Carolina against Gene Katie's Purdue team in 96 in Albuquerque. It will happen one day. The balance in basketball has changed dramatically in the last 15 to 20 years. It's hard for a 1 seed to come out and bring it against 16s. Year in and year out, these teams are getting closer and closer to climbing that ladder as Dante Taylor commits the foul. Williams, the jumping jack that he is, taking it to the rack.
Here's the play, and I like it when a player is aggressive like that because it really forces the referee to make a call right there. And against Dante Taylor, he's so long, he averages, he's got 22 blocks on the year. So he's a presence inside, and you can't be weak against that. You have to go right at him.
Over on CBS, Ian Eagle and Jim Spanarkle have the Princeton-Kentucky game. It's now 55-51. Yeah, Calipari's team at the under four mark. And an 8-2 run, as Greg Gumbel documented a moment ago, and they've held on to that lead. But don't sleep on Princeton. That team, junior, senior laden against a very young Wildcats team, as seemingly Calipari's teams will always be with his system in place at Lexington. Gibbs pumps. Count it.
Yeah, you know, it seems almost like he was a little passive, and a lot of times big scorers will let other guys work into the offense, but Ashton Gibbs has been focused on his scoring here in the second half.
14 points for him, Mike. 8 in this half. They're inviting Williams to take that shot up at the top of the key.
Well, and if he continues to make it, it may compel them to come out of the zone, which is going to be tough.
Quinard Jackson, tough shot. Ashton Gibbs has been calling his own number of late, but he really knows how to distribute, too. Pittsburgh team has a lot of different guys that can bring it up. And then they get into their half-court set and have a committee of points. Trayvon Woodall being one of them. Stevenson the rebound. Williams gives it up to Prim. That's his spot. Off the front iron this time, and a push. Now spotted underneath. You know, we were talking about the Kentucky-Princeton game back in 89 on 116. There's one of the all-time greats of Adolph Rupp, one of Rupp's runs back in the 60s at Riley.
Going on to have an incredible coaching career, and now had a one of the biggest off seasons that any GM and president has had in NBA history, getting the big three to come down to the Heat.
Had a lot to do, as you see Prim off the inbounds getting that hoop. He had a lot to do with the motion picture Glory Road, which documented Texas Western and the Bear, Don Haskins, and that 66 game that really changed the face of college basketball for so many. Pat had a lot to do with that picture being made. Addison dumps it inside, and a foul underneath as Robinson, Nasir Robinson, gets racked up by Stevenson. Well, for instant analysis and highlights of every tournament, game that we have, we invite you to log on to SI.com. Nasir Robinson at the free throw line. Think of all of those players, Mike, that were on that 66 team for Kentucky. No player over 6'4". Louis Dampier, Larry Conley, a colleague and friend of ours.
Yep.
Larry worked many an NCAA tournament for CBS.
Our friend Gary Williams was at Cole Fieldhouse, and
that's
he
right.
said he snuck into that game to see it.
He sure did. That was before he actually played there.
Yeah, try sneaking into an NCAA Final Four now.
Yeah,
that'd
I don't
be a little
think
bit
it would
more
happen.
Difficult.
I don't think it would happen. And it's hard to believe John Williams picks up that foul. Hard to believe, but this is true. That Final Four and national championship game was syndicated, Mike. It was not seen nationally. No network had it. Only a very few people around the country had a chance to see it. Well, if you'd like to make a donation to help in the ongoing relief effort for the disaster in Japan, we invite you to log on to cnn.com/impact. Patterson, the offensive rebound. Again, just not a fair fight underneath. Out of bounds. Boy, Robinson going over Bill Hillgrove and Dick Grote, the broadcasters for Pittsburgh. Dick Grote, a Hall of Famer, and Bill Hillgrove, one of the all-time great play-by-play men, also does games for the Steelers. That was scary. You can see Dick trying to hold him up.
Yeah, he went right into, and then everybody coming over checking one of the greatest guys in our profession, and Dick Grote went flying back into stands there, and he went into a pole pretty hard.
Bill trying to help him up.
First retired jersey for basketball at Duke University back in 1952.
Baseball Hall of Famer, basketball Hall of Famer, Dick Grote.
Yeah, and still tough, can still absorb a blow right now. But had a great conversation with him yesterday, getting the ins and outs of this Pittsburgh team. He's still very vibrant.
So many legends when you think about it in sports from Pittsburgh, and athletically as well as in our business, the broadcasting business. Hillgrove and Grote, just two of them. Dickey stop and go against McGee, and I think McGee picked up the foul. That was a mismatch. How good was he, Mike? And I know you just think the world of him.
Well, you know, in his senior game, dropping 50 or 52 on North Carolina, and you know what the thing is, and he gets a hand from the crowd, and he's loving it. Bill leading the cheers, but yeah. He told me, and he's, you know, he played on a world championship with the 64 Cardinals.
That's right.
Was a great, great baseball player, and he said he would have traded it all for a career in basketball. That was his first love.
Played with McCarver and those guys in 64. In traffic, Dickey goes down. McGee just in the wrong place at the wrong time. You know, I'm looking at poor Gary McGee. 6'10", 250, and he's like, okay, I was off balance and just happened to be in the wrong place, I guess.
Well, it was the jump and the pump fake they landed. You know, it looked a little different from here on the first angle, but it was clearly a leg whip.
No question, but, you know, I feel badly for him because he clearly had lost his balance. Sort of like, let's call a foul on the bigger guy. He was in the wrong place at the wrong time. So two fouls on McGee in less than 15 seconds. Jamie Dixon is going to get Gilbert Brown back onto the floor to replace Nasir Robinson. Prim and Dickey have been carrying UNC Asheville offensively. No one else really able to scratch. They have the last 14 points for the Bulldogs. Stevenson not there. And that foul committed by Williams against Trayvon Woodall.
Right now, if a guy for Pitt, I mean, we talked about the fact that Gibbs has started to come alive, but Brad Wanamaker has had a fairly quiet game so far. Only two field goal attempts. He's got 6 points. He's perfect from the floor. But this is a guy that usually gives you 12 points a game.
That foul on John Williams, by the way, was his third. Wanamaker, the Philadelphia star, just the eighth player in Pitt history with 1,000 points and 400 assists. Woodall. Out there. Stevenson clears it right to Prim. He's got Dickey with him. Crossover. Look to get it to Dickey. Wonderful defensive play by McGee as well as Lamar Patterson. They just will not give up on any play.
Before you say anything, it was 1995.
It was 93.
Kenny, 1995 was the year the song came out.
It was 93.
That was your fifth year of high school. It was 1995.
10 bucks says it's 93.
Yeah, well, that's 10 bucks you're going to have to put in my pocket.
Whatever. One there it is, it was 93.
It was clearly 1990. Kenny, the restaurant's on fire. I'll call you back.
Wait.
In the network, AT&T lets your iPhone talk and surf the web at the same time.
Have you tried one of these? It's so good.
Man, I can't believe we haven't done this before.
Oh, wow, look at that.
A bite.
Oh, shit. Your agent. Do the jingle. Do the jingle.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, guys.
Do it again. Do it again.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
In my office.
State Farm.
I think we're good.
State Farm agents are there when you need them.
Why is everyone trying to kill me?
You were part of the plan.
They think you are him. Let it go.
The Tourist. Get it on Blu-ray and DVD March 22nd.
Our number one thing in our system is speed and explosive power. And I would list speed three times. We want to be fast, we want to be efficient, and we're going to be explosive. I want people that went out at Heinz Field to not sit down in their seat. We're excited to bring a high-energy, innovative, high-octane approach, and that's the type of football that we're going to play.
You've never seen fast. You've never held it in your hand, then unleashed it with a fingertip. Never watched pixels whip by at 1 gigahertz and had your neurons struggle to keep up. You've never seen fast because you've never seen this. The Droid Incredible by HTC. It's nothing short of its name.
Now get the Droid Incredible by HTC for $99.99.
Coming to TNT, the unforgettable moments. The NBA playoffs begin April 17th on TNT.
Pittsburgh with the lead, and a reminder, good coverage of the Division I Women's Basketball Tournament at NCAA.com/Final Four. Timeout with 36 seconds remaining. Kentucky and Princeton over on CBS. Ian Eagle and Jim Sparkle have a stem winder. If you'd like to check it out, we invite you to do so. As we continue with an inbounds play to Williams, who is skying for that alley-oop. Dickey. Nice opportunity on a putback that doesn't fall for Stevenson. Just heartbreak hotel in that sequence for UNC Asheville.
Three really good looks.
Those are the opportunities against that defense that you have to convert one of them.
They're 2 for 15 from beyond the arc. Brown tries to tip it in. McGee, the putback, has it slapped away, but Dickey's out of bounds.
Frustrating game so far for Gilbert Brown, but look at this out of bounds play. Very well conceived, but tipped out at the end. And Gilbert Brown, the best athlete for Pitt, goes up and foils that play. But then on the other end, another easy opportunity on a stick back that they don't get.
And you hear the term pesky for underdogs quite a bit, and it certainly applies for these Bulldogs of UNC Asheville. Outmanned, undersized, but just like gnats flying around you. They just won't let go. Hits. Off the inbounds pass, it's the two-pointer to fall.
Yeah, that's a little bit too easy right there. It was just one screen, one pass, and he gets an open look from 12 feet.
Pittsburgh with more rebounds than Asheville has points, and that's by a pretty large sum.
Hey, Tim, that the UNC Asheville makes a little bit of a response.
And Kentucky has taken a two-point lead in that game against Princeton. There's an offensive foul. UNC Asheville, with the help of Dickey, Gilbert Brown picks up the personal. That's his second.
Illegal screen that time at the front, trying to get Gibbs a look.
Just a couple of ticks remaining in that Princeton-Kentucky game. But they do get one last gasp.
That's a, you bet they're going to try for a three, not try to extend against that team.
What a remarkable second round it has been on this Thursday afternoon. Literally in every sight. All of our announced teams have had a very special moment at each one of the four sites for today's games, as Dickey had it stripped but deflected off his shin by Wanamaker, and it'll go back the other way. Eddie Beatenpower just pleading with Chris Rastatter, the official, for a break.
Brad Wanamaker's a terrific defender, did a nice job sliding his feet, and just so much more physical than Matt Dickey.
Over Cunningham, that three ball for Brown won't go, and yet again, with the effort expended by Williams, he's the last to touch it. Well, TruTV presents an all-new series, Big Brian, the Fortune Seller, every Tuesday at 10. You won't believe what happens when he turns a house full of memories into the sale of the century.
How many times do you see that, a fractured play, and the defense gets scattered, and the other team gets a wide-open look at the three?
Well, John Calipari's team by a whisker. The Cats move on with their victory over the Princeton Tigers by two. Dickey looking inside to Williams. On the wing, J.P. Krim. And Cunningham and McGee get tied up, and the foul appears to be against Cunningham. Gibbs has really been shouldering the responsibility in this half, hasn't he?
Yeah, making plays inside, 7 of 13. Been aggressive, but where he's done a lot of his work is behind the three-point line. 5 of 8 from beyond the arc, and on the year, 48% in from there.
19 points, 13 of them in this half.
Leading the Big East in that category.
Cunningham, by the way, with that undercut, committing his fourth foul, so Eddie Beatonball will get him out of the game. And UNC Asheville, again, that front line playing the back line of that 2-3 zone is anchored by Kennard Jackson, all 6'5 of him. That's being generous. Williams goes 6'4, it's Stevenson 6'4. Brown, Gilbert Brown hits a three ball. Largest lead of the day, 56-39 Pittsburgh.
Yeah, it's just been a war of attrition. Eddie Beatonball sees it.
8:16 remaining. The old coach knows his team won't give up. We'll be right back.
Applebee's 2 for 20 fans just can't get enough.
Hi, Sarah.
Hey, it's my 2 for 20 club.
Back for new Bourbon Street entrees.
Oh, yeah.
Bourbon Street?
I see we have a new member.
Welcome to the club.
Because 2 for 20 is now jazzed up with the flavors of Bourbon Street. New Bourbon Street chicken and shrimp and Cajun shrimp pasta. Plus favorites like the 7-ounce house sirloin. One appetizer, two entrees, $20. 2 for 20 now with the flavors of Bourbon Street. Only at Applebee's. There's no place like the neighborhood. Open till midnight or later.
17-point lead for the Pittsburgh Panthers, but score not really indicative of how tough it has been against UNC Asheville. The difference really in this second half, not just the play of Gibbs, but overall UNC Asheville not hitting open looks from downtown. They are 0 for 5 from three-point range in this half. Pitt, on the other hand, is 4 out of 8.
Yeah, and it's been a different team, and I think it shows the difference between not having played since last week and Asheville getting a run a couple days ago. But Pitt has been much better offensively in this second half.
Grimm and Dickey have shouldered most, if not all, of the scoring responsibility in this half. Krim off the bounce. Few of those have just absolutely got to fall, and they get a hard luck play as Stevenson tried to get it inside to Williams, threw it right in between his legs. Timeout in D.C., and the 16th seed is trying to hang in.
Cardiology, I don't have a heart. Pulmonary doctor, no cigar. I can't diagnose a simple cold or flu, but if your engine's got a cough, I know what to do. Give it 6 of these and wash it down with this. A new air filter ought to help it catch its breath. Now, but know how.
Lawn gnomes, bird baths, and the competition are officially on notice. Introducing Craftsman Turntide Tractors, a best-in-class 8-inch turning radius, 30% tighter than any other tractor. Craftsman, trust in your hands.
If you have the audacity to believe that a financial advisor should look you in the eye when the topic is your money,
join the nearly 7 million investors who think like you do. FaceTime and ThinkTime make a difference. At Edward Jones, it's how we make sense of investing.
Gout's root cause is high uric acid. If you have gout, high uric acid can lead to more attacks. To help reduce attacks, lower your uric acid. Uloric lowers uric acid levels in adults with gout. It's not for the treatment of high uric acid without a history of gout. Uloric reduces uric acid to help you reach a healthy level.
Don't take Uloric if you are taking azathioprine, mercaptopurine, or theophylline. Gout may flare when starting Uloric. don't stop taking it. Your doctor may give you other medicines to help prevent flares. A small number of heart attacks, strokes, and heart-related deaths were seen in studies. It's not certain Ulorik caused them. Certain tests to check liver function may be required. Tell your doctor about liver or kidney problems or history of heart disease or stroke. The most common side effects are liver problems, nausea, gout flares, joint pain, and rash.
If you have gout, ask your doctor about Ulorik.
With available features like the Harman Kardon 5.1 Matrix Surround System, 10 gigs of music storage, 384 watts of power, 11 speakers, and 3 months of satellite radio, the best entertainment system in your house won't always be in your house. The 2011 LaCrosse from Buick.
As you look at our game summary, the disparity from beyond the arc is obvious, but this is a 15-4 run, and Ashton Gibbs is responsible for 8 of those 15. Really a business-like approach by this Pittsburgh team in the second half.
Well, and I think, too, what they've done with Prim and Dickey is they've taken away the three-point opportunities and made them drivers, and without a post presence, the perimeter guys for Pitt have been able to lock in on people.
Brown gets some help from McGee and Wanamaker. Wanamaker's trap and a steal by Prim. Dickey on the wing. Hello. Those two have been the difference trying to maintain contact in this game. 56-42. That's going to be a block against Prim, his fourth.
On Eddie Biedenbaugh, this is the last resort, getting out, full court pressure, trying to turn Pitt over. The first result, good. And, you got to wonder at some point in time if Trevon Woodall is going to come back in as that third ball handler.
Yeah, Trevon has made a bit of a difference. Now we talk about Jamie Dixon, and I know his dad's very proud of his son. His father, Jim, is here watching his son coach this team. Talking to Pat Riley there among those around, and it's a basketball family in many respects, and probably no doubt remember the documented story about Jamie's sister Maggie, who was an outstanding coach at Army, who died prematurely, and the classic named in her honor for basketball packed the Garden in New York, Mike, earlier this year, and Jamie was so proud of that. I talked to him every week during the course of the regular season, and the week of that event, he was there for it. Could not have been more proud of the crowd that was on hand for that matchup.
Well, he picks the teams, and he's trying to get UConn, as Gino Auriemma, ready to go. They're trying to get Tennessee on board for that event.
And by the way, he could be the Frank Sinatra to Martin and Lewis if he can get Pat Summit and Gino together these days. You have to be quite the conduit if he can bring those two back together again. For years, those two teams met. In fact, in some years, they met twice a season. It's almost like a conference game. Well, check out the Powerade 4-point performance ranking system to get a peek into the science behind tournament success. See where your team ranks at NCAA.com. Powerade. Powerade performance rankings.
And things look bright for UNC Asheville. We talked about the backcourt of Dickey and Prim. They're both juniors, so they'll be back next year.
And they have the last 21 points, Mike, for UNC Asheville. Still a 14-point game. Prim sitting with the four fouls. Trevon Woodall, as you mentioned, back into the game and handling the rock as they get it beyond half court. Clock winding down, Woodall. McGee. Sometimes a missed shot is as good as a pass, particularly with Gary McGee underneath there. Stubbs, Eric Stubbs, the senior from West Palm Beach. It's his second foul.
Number 52, Eric McGee, shooting two.
44 blocks coming into the game. Five double-doubles this year for Gary McGee. Let's go over to Lewis Johnson. Lewis.
Well, Tim, despite this 14-point lead, Jamie Dixon has been really busy in the timeouts, working that grease board. Frustrated earlier that UNC Asheville was grabbing some layups, just too easy. Really talked to his guys a lot about taking care of the possessions as this game winds down, and the importance of rebounding and also making them, UNC Asheville, guard us. That was what he said.
Yeah. You know, so many guys, Mike, are derivatives of other coaches, and he played at Cal Santa Barbara for Jerry Pym. Many people connect the dots to Ben Howland, and understandably so, because he worked for him at Northern Arizona and then later at Pittsburgh. But Jerry Pym is also responsible for much of the knowledge and love of the game. As you see, Williams again miss an easy one on an oop.
Well, Rick Majerus too, a part of that, part of the mentors.
Yep.
For footballs in line with the Ben Howland tree.
Ashton Gibbs, and a steal by Trayvon Woodall. Easy one coming for Nasir Robinson. And the floodgates may have opened here. 63-44, Pittsburgh by 19.
And Jamie Dixon is still teaching, still coaching, wanting to solidify that defense, looking to the next round in the matchup against Butler.
22-9 this run for Pittsburgh. Well, the UNC Asheville's credit. They have remained disciplined through all of this. They just haven't gotten shots to fall. And no one other than Dickey and Prim can find a cylinder to be accepting. Foul underneath.
Well, here, yeah, this is just where the margin of error is so thin. Those are the ones you absolutely have to convert. Especially a guy like Williams right up there at the rim. Looked a little bit like David Thompson when they didn't have the, when you couldn't dunk and he just missed the layup. He was certainly there to finish.
Amazing to think that one of the greatest games ever played, Mike, involving David Thompson, North Carolina State, that 74 game in the ACC tournament with our colleague Lynn Elmore and Lucas and those guys at Maryland, that the loser of that game could not play in the NCAA tournament.
Not only that, Tim, but North Carolina was ranked in the top five that year as well. Three teams in the top five all year long, and only one of them was going.
Sometimes changing with the times is a good thing. I think that game had as much to do with expansion of the NCAA tournament as any game. Get it up to 32 and then on to 48 before we went to 64 back in 1985. UNC Asheville coming with a full court pressure again.
Well, and they've got three guards on the floor with Woodall and Wanamaker. Tough to press this team.
Woodall with a beautiful dish. Dropped it off to Gilbert Brown, and he's fouled. And the winner of this game is advancing to take on Butler. What a performance they had. And with their two big guys in foul difficulty the entire second half, Andrew Smith and Matt Howard managed to stay in the game long enough. And without those two, Mike, they would not have been able to pull off the heroics at the buzzer.
It was Smith who kept it alive on an errant shot that Howard able to corral it and get it up for the win.
Van Zant literally threw up a prayer as he lost balance on a dribble drive. And I'd be curious to know if Smith felt that Matt Howard was there. He may have been looking for a tip in himself, but the ball just went right into Howard's hands as he went to the rack and laid it in off the glass.
Well, that's going to be an interesting matchup because neither of Pitt's centers are really offensive-minded, and Smith really impressed me today with his positioning. He's going to need to stay out of foul trouble in that game, but I think he could be a big factor.
Well, we had said all along that either Old Dominion or Butler would have been a great opponent for Pitt in this third round come Saturday. And the foul spotted as Lane was trying to make this move, and Trayvon Woodall got in position to collect the player control foul.
Bulldogs 10 team fouls.
10 team fouls now. Four and change remaining. All that separates Jamie Dixon from round two. Yeah. Taylor looking to set the pick. Wanamaker lost it, but there's Gibbs to pick it up. John Williams the rebound.
Dickey. Lane, he's fouled. Wanamaker got his hand in there. And he picks up the foul.
There's that play, and that, no, he was just trying to keep it alive, oh, Tim. Yeah. And but it's just, you know, sometimes good things happen when you do that, and great players make plays like that. And Matt Howard was terrific today.
Yep. And think about it, as we said, he was the guy that set the pick for Gordon Hayward's half-court heave last year against Duke. The final score in that game, 61-59. Today they win 60-58.
Prim with the pilfer.
Should have thought about getting it to a guard that time instead of putting it on the deck.
Dickey, hang time. Boy, Matt Dickey. This young man from Trustville, Alabama is so tough, isn't he?
He's a big time player, and I love guys who will step up and make big shots.
On the other end, the slam for Dante Taylor.
I've always been a big proponent of it, that you attack pressure to score at the other end, and hit very aggressive that time. Dante Taylor getting the finish.
Prim in traffic. That'll be a block. So he'll get his opportunity after Taylor commits the foul. Matt Dickey, we may only see him once, but Matt, we will remember you. Oh, yes, we will.
Sometimes history is made in the sky, in a lab, in a living room, on a launch pad, on a stage, in a garage. And now, at the end of a power cord, introducing the extended range electric Volt from Chevrolet.
My first ride lasted just 30 seconds. Another reminder of what I couldn't do. The accident could have been my excuse to quit. I made it my reason to go even harder.
Helping people achieve without limits. At the Hartford, it's what we do and why we're the founding partner of the U.S. Paralympic team.
LG and Best Buy bring you every game anywhere you are. And save money with awesome 3-year, no-interest financing on LG home theater purchases, $8.99 and up. Never miss a March moment at Best Buy.
Cut! What's that doing on my set?
Product placement, sir. Whenever we feature a product in a scene, we get tons of free stuff.
Here we go.
Really? My lady.
A sure sign of a good time. Just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
More Bud Light?
A house packed with hidden treasure.
You know what this is worth?
And hidden danger. Every Tuesday.
What the hell's going on?
It all goes up first save. Go! Big Brian the Fortune Seller premieres every Tuesday at 10 on TruTV.
Tournament update time. Greg Dumble in New York, taking you to the West, where number 2 seed San Diego State having a tough time shaking Northern Colorado. Chase Tapley with a 3 here. They're at the half. San Diego State leads at 30-24. That game taking place on TNT. Let's send you back to Washington.
Kawhi Leonard is a really special talent, Greg, no doubt about that. Kevin Harlan, Reggie Miller, and Dan Bonner have that one underway over on TNT. We've got Prim at the free throw line for UNC Asheville. And a reminder, outstanding matchups coming up tonight. We mentioned Cal Santa Barbara back in the day. They'll be taking on Florida tonight. Wofford, BYU, our game, Bucknell against Connecticut. And Belmont and Wisconsin. A lot of people have Rick Byrd's team making noise coming out of that league. And, you know, they scared Duke big time not long ago.
And we know that Bo Ryan's team sometimes have been offensively challenged. So if they get in a game without scoring that well. And that first game, I think Billy Donovan might have done one of his best coaching jobs this year with that ball club.
You know, short of the poor performance in the SEC championship game against Kentucky,
yep,
they had really played well the last half of the season. Senior laden club too, guys that have come along. Tyus and
Vernon Macklin, Chandler Parsons,
Georgetown transfer. I think that Chandler Parsons is one of the best all court, full court players. Can pass it, shoot it,
good assist guy. Yep,
beat you off the dribble. He is a fantastic talent. A little bit like Derek Williams of Arizona, I think unsung. Not many people around the country know as much about him as they possibly should. Dickey looking inside. Williams pops out. Again, just no one able to scratch other than Prim and Matt Dickey for UNC Asheville. It's almost been 2 against 5 offensively in the second half for the Bulldogs. And credit Pittsburgh's defense. One thing about this team, they'll never stop playing D, right?
Yeah, and you see the rebounds right there, just a dominant performance. I talked with Jamie Dixon yesterday about the psychology of 116, and he said, hey, you know what, this is our next opponent.
Yep.
And I thought that they were a little sluggish in the first half, but it was just almost like just going in and getting the rust off. In the second 20 minutes, they played more like Pitt can normally play.
Grimm lost his dribble. Patterson trying to feed Taylor. Nice recovery by Dante. And for the first time, the Panthers lead by 20 with just over 2 remaining in the game.
Well, some good minutes for the sophomore right there, McGee, and playing a bulk of the minutes. But Taylor coming in, averaging 5 points, 5 rebounds. So getting some court time. And he could be a factor in the game against Butler, Tim. If they get McGee in foul trouble, he's going to have to step up and play.
Toles Hartman was fouled. Well, the Butler-Pittsburgh game we touched on a few moments ago, the matchup in that one, one would think in that game, Mike, they're going to have to get more open looks for Shelvin Mack, and he'll have to take advantage of every one of them if they were to maintain contact in that game, don't you think?
No, absolutely, and, you know, especially from the three-point line, you can put a lot of pressure. Be an interesting matchup between him and Ashton Gibbs.
Hartman, a youngster from Christiansburg, Virginia. North Cross High School, unable to get it to go. Woodall comes out of there with it. Trayvon Woodall feeds Gibbs. Classic. Textbook Pittsburgh from an offensive standpoint. Jamie Dixon does not want to take the entire time out. He just wants to get his starters off the floor, let some other guys log some playing time, and the Pittsburgh fans can give guys like Gibbs and Taylor the kind of ovation they deserve. J.J. Moore is going to get out there for the first time.
It's been a very physical game out there, even for their radio color analyst. Dick Rowe taking his lumps early on. We hope he's okay. But Ashton Gibbs, after a very slow start, 20 of his 26 in the second half.
I know what my friend and longtime colleague Dino Cook was probably concerned about Dick Rowe. Dino is, I hope, resting comfortably in the hospital in Pittsburgh. We send you good wishes and prayers, my friend. The media room at Pittsburgh's facility is named after Dino, a legendary football historian and originally a sports information director at Pitt. Brown comes down with a rebound for Pitt.
Well, it's just one of those games where the first 20 minutes, I'm sure there were a lot of teaching points for Jamie Dixon at halftime with his ball club. But they came out and performed very, very well. They took care of business in the second 20.
They really did. And for Eddie Biedenbaugh and his lovely wife, Barbara, it was a short stay, but a memorable one. What a trip from Dayton into here and the opportunity to entertain. And you know what? For a 16-1 game, and we've done our fair share of them, this has been an entertaining game, Mike.
Yeah, no, the memories of having to play in that in the first four and then getting here and the police escort to the hotel, big-time stuff for the Bulldogs.
And these kids, Trent Meyer, Josh Seligson, Madison Davis, Jeremy Harn, young men, they're going to be able to say we were in the box score of the NCAA tournament. Special move on Eddie's part.
He's got a golf event in late August. He wants us to make it. You want to drive my cart?
I drive you everywhere else. I might as well do that.
J.J. Richardson got hammered inside, and he'll get to the free throw line for two.
I know you'd make it from the 18th hole to the clubhouse, but I'd be worried about everything else.
Is that's where I'm really dangerous, from 18 to 19. Richardson, a sophomore from Missouri City, Texas. A lot of playing time a year ago. Today was entertaining. I think tonight's going to be even more fun.
Boy, what matchups we've got.
Bucknell, no stranger to upsets. I know Jim Calhoun very concerned about that game.
Plus, that Cincinnati-Missouri game is one of the most highly anticipated matchups of the second round. Meyer's shot won't fall, and it's pulled down by Richardson, and that should do it. Jamie Dixon's Pittsburgh Panthers, the number one seed, win it 74-51, leading only by five at halftime. But they just... took apart UNC Asheville on the glass, and ultimately that was the difference en route to this victory by 23. So we look at our Southeast Region brackets. Pittsburgh advances, punching their ticket to take on the Butler Bulldogs, the eighth seed here in Washington, D.C. on Saturday.
Well, that's an eighth seed, but it's a team that's the national runner-up from last year, and they are going to be a very dangerous opponent.
No question. And from a matchup standpoint, maybe as good as it gets in a third-round matchup against a top seed. Enjoyed it, my friend. We'll have a lot of fun tonight.
Let's tee it up on the back nine later on.
Yeah, why not? We'll play two again. How about that? For Lewis Johnson and Mike Gminski, Tim Brando saying so long from Washington, D.C. The tournament continues with games now on TNT and TBS. TruTV returns at 7 Eastern with the Infinity NCAA tip-off, followed by Wisconsin and Belmont. We'll send you to our studio right after these messages. Bye-bye from our nation's capital.